I'm Sasha Rabchevsky. I'm a professor of physiology in the College of Medicine, the University of Kentucky, and I'm a core faculty member of the Spinal Cord and Brain Injury Research Center here in Lexington, Kentucky. So my interest in spinal cord injury research stemmed from an accident, a motorcycle accident I had when I was the age of 19 years old. Sophomore in college, ready to play football for Division III school. Through time, after rehabilitation, I realized that what I really wanted to do was not obviously play football anymore, but I wanted to pursue research, but to be able to understand what was my condition, and if not cure it, figure out and understand why it was that there is no cure for spinal cord injury. In particular, what my laboratory has been and is focused on are two primary problems. One is the spread of the initial injury, like a bruising effect. We are using compounds that are targeting specific pathways that reduce the inflammatory response and let's say even the swelling, so that whatever the initial insult occurred, you are going to mitigate or prevent any further damage so that the possibility for recovery is increased exponentially. We've come up with some very novel methods that are recently funded by the NIH in which we are using pharmacological agents to prevent the dysfunction of what are called mitochondria. And mitochondria are basically an organelle inside the cell that is responsible for both the life of the cell as well as the death. So it's kind of a conundrum. And so what we're using is pharmacological agents to stabilize the integrity of the mitochondria so that it prevents secondary cell death. The second condition that we study is actually something that I myself suffer. It is an autonomic dysfunction. How can we restore their autonomic functions, whether it's breathing, bowel and bladder, as well as other instances such as blood pressure regulation, which are very, very important because the spinal cord injury population, being sedentary, has a high-risk cardiovascular disease. But there is regeneration that occurs after spinal cord injury, and a lot of it. It doesn't form any proper connections, and instead what happens is in this condition, autonomic dysreflexia, which we study, when you have a painful stimulus below the level of the injury, what it causes is a massive rise in blood pressure. And the individual, myself, doesn't really know why it's occurring, and there's no shutoff mechanism for it to happen. So we're trying to study in that context how we can ironically prevent this aberrant plasticity or regeneration that leads to things that are not necessarily good for the human condition. We've been approved for funding to pursue a new approach to, instead of protecting mitochondria, we are actually going to be the first laboratory to actually transplant isolated mitochondria into individuals with spinal cord injury. Now, obviously, we're working on this with animal models, but the goal is, and this is why I think the investments have been so high with our granting agencies, it's a high risk, but a very high reward. So we're very excited, and the momentum in our laboratory is growing with this. We now have recently, actually within the past 3 months, recruited two new spinal cord injury faculty because of the momentum that we have here. What I really like about this environment is that while everything is competitive, it's not cutthroat. It's not, there isn't this sense of somebody looking over your back waiting to steal your data. And I see that in a lot of these other big institutions. And I think that's what the opportunity you have with the Land Grant Institute, as well as with the K-Shirt funds, because we have a very unique commonwealth, one of the few in the United States, that actually uses drunk driving and speeding ticket monies to subsidize research funds. So this is within state, and it's between the University of Louisville and University of Kentucky that we compete for these funds. Every semester, I have up to 4 to 5 undergraduate researchers who rotate to the laboratory and learn spinal cord injury techniques and the most state-of-the-art methods to take care of animals. And this is very critical because a lot of these students are going to go on and apply to medical schools. And so they use the experience that they've had in my laboratory in order to blossom their own careers and fields. It's also nice when you get down an email or even a real letter. Nobody does that anymore. But from a former student who thanks me for something that I did 6 years ago. So it really does mean a lot to me too. In other words, to be engaged one-on-one with undergraduates as well as graduates and medical students.